नमस्कार एंड वेलकम टू द न्यू सीरीज ऑफ आर्ट स्टोरीज। व्हेन वी स्पीक अबाउट आर्ट वी थिंक अबाउट ब्यूटी, क्रिएटिविटी, एस्थेटिक्स, एलिगेंस, इमेजिनेशन एंड सो मच। ऑल दीज कंबाइंड विद द हार्ड वर्क मेक्स अ पर्सनैलिटी लाइक दैट ऑफ डॉक्टर सुचिता भिडे चापेकर। 50 years back, a young, brilliant, graceful dancer caught an eye of the audiences of Mumbai. Not only Mumbai, but all over Maharashtra. And for the first time probably, the Maharashtrian audiences were exposed to the aesthetics, elegance, authenticity and subtlety of Bharatanatyam. And yes, that artist was Dr. Suchita Bhide Chapekar, who is the guest for this episode and this series. Namaste, Suchita Tai, and Namaste. A warm welcome to you to this series of art stories. We would like to know all about you, your thoughts, your experiences on many topics, because I think the strong foundation which creates a veteran artist like you will be a food for thought for all the upcoming artists. Let's go down the memory lane and begin at your childhood, because that again creates a strong foundation. Did you grow up in Mumbai? And yes. You did your schooling in Mumbai, I think.
Yes.
So please share your experiences from school time.
Well, going down the memory lane, that's not me really. I don't always think of the past, or maybe if I think to learn something from those experiences and look more ahead. But this program has given me that opportunity, and I'm happy to indulge into the past. At the very outset, I would also like to thank the entire Art Stories team for inviting me here, Mukta D'Souza and everybody else. Thinking of childhood, I really had very carefree, happy childhood. I was born in Pune, but brought up in Mumbai. My father was an artist, a painter. Actually, his father was a teacher in New English School, Pune, teaching Sanskrit and English. And his elder brother went for medical, but naturally, my grandfather expected that he would also take up some studies like science or engineering. But in spite of not having any artist in the family, I don't know from where my father got this aspiration to become a painter, artist. And at age of 16, with, as he used to say, just 4 annas in his half-pant pocket, he left for Mumbai. His father's cousin, his uncle, was artist. So he went to him, stayed with him like Guru Kulavasa, did everything, cooking, washing utensils, everything, and for 2 years learned painting. Because in those conditions, it was not possible for him to attend art school or any such institution, but he had the practical training. M.R. Bhide, his uncle, he was in film line. He used to, those years, the posters which were displayed on the streets were painted, hand painted.
Okay.
So he introduced my father to Sourabh Modi. You might have heard his name. The first director who prepared talkie movie. So he introduced my father to him, and he saw his hand and was so happy. He was bowled over. At age of 18, he got a job with Minerva Movietone and Tardev, which also later on was going to become my second home. So he got a studio in Central Studios, Tardev, where now the huge air-conditioned market is there. That whole place were studios.
Okay.
Somehow my father had this idea that his baby was going to become a dancer. I don't know why. He used to tell me that whenever any music started, I used to do freehand gestures and dance. So that I must have been just 3 or 4.
Oh.
So he thought of course, dance for him, though he was in film line, it was always classical. I don't know why. So there was a master coming next door.
Okay.
His name was Tulsidas Mangeshkar. He was distant relation of the Dinanath Mangeshkar family. Himself a young person, a very good dancer himself. That must have been 52 or 53. I was just 5 years old.
Okay.
And that was the time when just the different styles, like there is Kathak, Bharatanatyam, Kathakali, just people were coming to know after independence. Nobody knew that we had so much of heritage and mm-hmm. so many traditions. So he started teaching me. He had taught me in 5 years, I learned 4 compositions. One in Kathak, one in Bharatanatyam, one in Kathakali and one in Manipuri. Kathak, it was Urvashi dance. I used to love Kathak very much because my mother had stitched a nice ghagra with broad jari border, and when I took wool, it used to flow and I was so
yes.
happy. Kathak was my most favorite. Then Alarpu in Bharatanatyam, some sari dance in Kathakali, and Rimijimi, Rimijimi, Nupura Bhaja, some song I still remember, some Nupura dance in Manipur. So after that, I remember that my brother's threat ceremony. My father was always, I wasn't so bold or, you know, outgoing kind of girl, just do with yourself, that kind. So there was a reception in Mumbai Scouts Pavilion Hall in Shivaji Park, and he said, whatever you know, you will dance.
Okay.
Maybe I was 7 years old, and I danced that. That was the thing. So now this Mangeshkar Masterji, he told my father, she knows all. And now you can do her programs. I was just 10. But I'm so happy to, when I think of those times, that my father said, maybe I'm an artist, but I know nothing, and I know nothing of dance, but I know that my daughter doesn't know anything. Who is your guru? She take us to him.
Oh.
Mm. So, that's how we landed in Parvati Kumar's place.
So, Acharya Parvati Kumar was your first guru.
Mangeshkar Master, I would say, he was also
he initiated
my guru
you.
Because my interest remained, and today I feel that I can watch each and every style, appreciate it. I think those roots were sown, those seeds were sown so early. In
yes.
time. I really appreciate every, you know, in our Parikrama festival we have had even Kalamandala and Kathakali artists. So I think he was my, like even when you are in Montessori, those ladies.
Somebody inspires you, somebody initiates.
They are your gurus, yes. They light some lamp of knowledge in your mind, so those are gurus.
And which school did you go to?
In Dadar, there was Balamohan Vidya Mandir. Actually, my father those years, he was very fond of cars, and Surab Modi gave him Austin of England. those years imported, because India manufactured only Fiat in Hindustan. So he was so fond of, he had a penchant for all the good things.
Good things.
Even my frocks and my dresses, few, but we would go to Marine Lines. There was one German, Beatrice, one tailor, and all my frocks will be, used to be from there. But I'm happy he did not put me in any convent school. Mm-hmm. Because that upbringing in Balmohan, in that Sanskriti, I feel that is important. Those samskars are important. Because Shivaji Park, we had Bombay Scottish, Konosa, so many convent schools. Mm-hmm. He could have easily put us, me and my brother, there, but no. And one reason was the school was just opposite our school.
Okay.
And Parvati Kumar Master, as we called him. Nowadays they'll say, oh, she's not even saying Masterji, but for us he was Master.
Master.
So Master was in, his house was Ganesh Prasad, Slater Road, Grant Road. So my father would take me in a car.
So you used to stay at Shivaji Park?
Yeah. Oh. And now it's not so much distance, but those days it was quite far.
Commuting was an effort.
7-8 miles from Dadar. So he would, early morning, he would, 7 o'clock, he would leave me in Masterji's place. And then he would go to his studio, which was nearby, would do his table work, some drawings, show card, and would pick me up at 10 and bring home. I used to just ogle some rice, something, and then run to school. Though it was at 10:30, I had special permission to miss the initial prayer and reach up to 11. So that was one advantage, that school was just opposite.
Close by. Yeah.
And my training could continue with Masterji. With Mangeshkar Master, I would say he himself danced very beautifully. He had very graceful style. Whatever he taught was very graceful. And so was with Master. Mm-hmm. Master himself has been a dancer, a genius, I would say, a born initiation, born urge to become a dancer.
Okay.
So when he started, probably Uday Shankar times, and he was motivated by that that dance, he also used to take name of Shanti Bardhan.
Okay.
Shanti Bardhan. I have never myself seen Shanti Bardhan's choreographies. Of course, Uday Shankar also we see through the Kalpana, his movie. But he was much charged with that. And he started working in that. Now, learning classical, for that Uday Shankar had also used all kind of styles. So he also went through that kind of training. He had to do a lot of effort because he didn't belong to any traditional family. But somehow he developed more taste for Bharatanatyam.
Okay.
And I think Rajarajeshwari Bharatanatya Kala Mandir, that was the only institution that time. Kupaya Pele sir was there. Established in Mumbai.
Yes.
And he went to them, he used to learn from them.
Okay.
So it was more, he got influenced
by that
by
style.
Bharatanatyam. But before that, he had choreographed many ballets. Like when I went, already his Dekhteri Bombay and several other ballets he had choreographed. And they were all through Indian National Theatre, INT. But the day I went, I was taken by my father. He put Mangeshkar Master, myself, in the car. And we went to Ganesh Prasad. That must have been the most fortunate thing in my life. I don't exactly remember what he asked me to dance or what I danced. But he accepted me as his student.
And how old were you at that time?
I must be 10, because 5 years already with Mangeshkar Master. So So then started really the training in Bharatanatyam. And even then Masterji would go to Rajarajeshwari. His wife was also a dancer. So those years the traditional gurus will not teach men, they would teach only ladies.
Oh.
So for Abhinaya he took Sumatai, his wife, to Gauriamma. And she would be in the front doing the thing and he would from behind the door.
You just cannot imagine that in these days.
He would watch and that's how he had learned those Yaro Evar Yaro Kanvan Vandari, those old padam. And I was taught those things. So that was a very learning period for me.
And we have heard that he was a very disciplinarian and very strict guru.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So how did, what was the methodology?
Strict, but somehow he called me Balya. Because I was always like little chubby that I was. He would call me. I was his pet probably. I saw the older students were really afraid of him. And somehow maybe I had started young and those years I think Nandu Shetty and those had already, he used to take their name. He had some students who, disciples who had already started performing.
So how did your class start always? Did it start with the warming up exercises or the adabus or the shlokas? What was the method?
7 o'clock. Precise, my father would have reached me to his place. He had small place, ground floor, so that nobody,
would get
no
disturbed.
Other people would mind. Later on, I remember upstairs, Prabhatre's sister used to stay. And after going there, she would rehearse only Sare Gama Padani, only the Saptak and Tanpura. So going to his house, everything would be quiet. So I would go to the balcony and listen to, who's this singer, who's this singer, so tuneful. So after a while, there was a small place, hall. I would come there, at least for half an hour, he would be inside in front of the puja thing.
Okay.
And would be busy in his puja. So initially I would say, why he calls me at 7 o'clock, my iron get up early and have bath and come. But slowly I realized in the room there were lot of bookshelves and lots of books. And somehow I had a lot of liking for which, I mean, I didn't know, but I love to read books and see books. So that started happening. And then till he came, I would take out this one, that one, and then I would ask him, what is this book about? You will come to know everything. So now looking back, I realized that to develop my taste, or probably he had gauged that I had this interest, which of course later on developed much when I did my master's and
research.
Went ahead and so that was one thing. Then of course adavus were the thing. He was very strict. He would himself get up and show and I had to do precisely that. At times I know I would, but why line? He'll say, no, this line is not correct. Do it again, do it. I would say, no, but okay, don't want to do it. Finish. Today's class is over. Go home. Practice it. But it has to go in that line. So that importance of Rekha, which is so important, one of the pranas of dancer, Javastiratvam, Rekha Cha, Brahmari, Drishti, Ashrama, Medha, Shraddha, Vacho, Gitam, Patra, Prana. So from that Rekha was so much etched on my. Well, all these things, when you are learning, you don't analyze or feel, but it gets absorbed. it's much later when I went to art school and compared dance and painting, and then these things started coming to my mind, really, why I was studying. Another incident I remember after our we started doing the Marathi compositions and got a lot of publicity in Mumbai papers. There once in Free Press, in front page there was a photo, Masterji and myself. So Masterji is standing like this and I am like this. See, this is what he talks of, Rick. See this, and see, I am like, you know, but he is like this. So again it synced, the importance of Rekha, why he is all the time, see.
Yes.
So this way it was, and for till 10 o'clock, for 3 hours, just master and dancing. Myself, there was no other student at that time. But simultaneously, I must say my school also, a lot of influences were happening. Today, when I think of them, everything I relate to dance.
Yes.
Till I was in school and I was learning from him, till my Arangetram, when I was 15, from 10 to 15, it was, I had strict instruction that I will not dance anywhere else. No, nothing.
Very important.
So in school, all my friends, they will take folk dance and bhangra and garba. I would sit in the class. And that time used to feel sad. But, you know, he had a point. He didn't want any other influence, probably. Wanted me to see deeply into what I was learning. But at that time, it used to be taxing. But why? But why? So,
till your Arangetram, you never performed in
any
public places.
But school had many more sanskars, which, see, now when I look back, I realize that, yes, everything now I relate to, I went on relating to dance. And dance is what I have.
Yes.
So, one incident I remember, you were in the same school, so you know the principal, Dada Saheb Rengi. He was a President Award winner for Best Teacher. One thing was there that he would, there must have been 800, more than 500, 800 students at that time. Now it's a very big school, 3,000 students. But he would remember everybody's name. When I late, after 10:30, I was running, he'll say, Bidanchi Nagatu Sucheta, Sauka, Sauka, Sambala, go slow. So now when I take general class, I know how important it is. Even when there are 20 or 25 students, I know each and every, I used to, now I don't. Now slightly my memory about names, everything else is
Patsput.
But it is so important when you take a, hey Prajakta, hey Chankela, this you did well, but little bit, this take care. If you take a name, that girl feels, yes, Thai is, otherwise at the back, front, only Thai looks only at the girls who stand in the front. So, knowing the name makes a lot of difference, and maybe those things sunk into me right from my school. Another incident, you know Dada,
yes,
so our principal, so you would know. In the morning, of course, then the classes, school had already become big and the prayer would be played on loudspeaker. And in the classes, we are supposed to stand with our hands joined, namaskar. So, we were very naughty that time. Me and two of my friends, we were same height and close friends. We would stand like your hand here. At the back end, we would do namas, like her hand here. Our hands were also so same. So in that, so every day during the prayer time, Dada would go from every class and as I say, why the back students are also important today, I realized. He noticed, though we were right in the back. So after the prayer was over, he said, come out. He was so afraid, but he said, do you know why we do namaste here? Why we combine the hands and do it here? It's concentration. Your mind, your intellect, your thoughts, everything you bring close to heart, and with everything you think of God the highest. So that's the process where it's the cleansing, internal cleansing, and you aim for the best. This, to this day, first thing in the class I explain this to my students. Devi, namaste. No, do it. Remember that you are bringing yourself together, not your thoughts are not meandering here and there. Now you are going to concentrate on your work. Few more things which I, samskar which I got in school, which later on in my so-called career or so-called my journey of dance, they helped me. One thing was, you will also remember, we used to have Hastakshar Saptah.
Yes.
So there was, I mean, now children will never understand doing this, what fun it was doing the handwriting. And there used to be competition and prizes for that. It may be a pencil or a pen, but that to get in the class to get the prize was very rewarding. And Shuddha Lekhan Saptaha, Hastakshar Saptaha. So my handwriting somehow was very good. Maybe later on when I help Masterji to write the whole manuscript of his book. And since my grandfather was an English teacher, his handwriting was good, and he taught me running hand, which later, of course, in art school we would do with crow quill.
Yes.
But I used to write, we were not allowed in school actually, but my English teacher at Lesser, he would appreciate and allow me to write in running hand. And me and my brother also had a good hand, but he used to say, you get prizes because you write with black ink. I said, you write with black ink, you will also win a prize. So it was not that. And much later, I don't exactly remember who gave me this, maybe in between, maybe Dr. Menon. This address of Dr. V. Raghavan, who was the founder and secretary of Music Academy, the highest cadre institution in Chennai, in Madras, then Madras. So I used to write long letters, this is the research and about it. And then he, as I found out later, he was a very terse, scholarly, very disciplined person. But inside, a very soft person as well. I would write long letters, and his would come one postcard. Yes, you can come and meet me. Okay. So my first trip to Chennai was in 72. And when we went to his house in Mylapore, we were staying in Woodlands. Of course, my father was always there that time. I never traveled alone. So both of us were there, and he comes out with a paper in his hand, my letter. Whose handwriting is this? He said, mine. It's good. It's nice. And then I got my first opportunity to, in the morning seminar session, my first opportunity to present Marathi composition.
Yes, now we know how important the upbringing, supports from the parents, schooling is in an artist's life to create such a strong foundation. We would like to know much more, but in the next episode. Stay tuned.